Hello and welcome to the glorious Glebe fishery up in Leicester. Here today to do one of my favourite tactics, a bit of shallow fishing on the pole. Sun's out, it's summer, fish are on the top cruising around, and hopefully we're going to catch a few today fishing shallow. So let's run you through the tactics I'm going to use in today, baits, rigs and how I'm going to fish. So starting off with the rigs I've set up today, I've not even got a plummet out, I'm just going to fish shallow. Fish are on the top, it's red hot. Been muggy for quite a few weeks, and the fish are, as you can see, cruising around enjoying the sunshine, so that's where we're going to fish for them. So I've set up two rigs today, really simple on the pole. First rig is a really simple 4x10 carp shallow. This is on my shorter rig, if you like. I've got 3 foot of line above the float. Here at the Glebe you're not allowed to, this is slap your rig. What they mean by that is sort of spin the rig over the top of the pole. It's all got to be laid in and laid flat. So I've got a shorter line for fishing sort of under the pole. When they do become a bit spooky, and when I do find a few fish cruising around like that one behind me, I've got a rig with a longer line and one of these new mugger floats. So this is a 414 mugger float. Both rigs have got all the shot directly under the float. That gives me a bit of weight and sort of weight to swing out towards the fish. It's a 414 float, it's quite heavy, but when I've got probably 5-6 foot of line above the float, you need that extra bit of weight to swing out and give you some control, really, especially if the wind gets up. And one of the biggest things about sort of flicking towards these fish down here is you need to be quite accurate, so having the right rig and the right float is really important to give you that control and make sure you put the rig right where you want it. So that's really simple, two rigs. Elastic wise, I've got 13 hollow. That's what I use for carp most of the time during the summer. I could step it up if it was bigger fish to a 15. Likewise, if it was like an F1 venue with the odd carp, I'd probably opt for maybe 11 hollow. So that's it, really simple, two pole rigs. I've also got a waggler rig just in case they back off, but hopefully we'll be all right today. Just 11 foot Superior X, 4 pound float max, and I've got one of the precision pellet wagglers, and I can chuck that to the far bank if they really back off, which might happen because, you know, it does happen when you're on sort of, there's only a couple people on the lake, so they do back off now and again. So that's it, really simple. Moving on to the bait. So the bait for today, for feed, I've got 6mm fin perfect pellets, really good pellets. They're a nice size, nice weight, uniform. They're ideal for pinging, they make lots of noise. So I'm gonna probably be fishing around 13, 14 meters where it's nice and comfortable. That gives me the option to feed there, but also flick a rig past it and all around. Depending on what the fish are doing, sometimes they might back off the feed, sometimes they might be in amongst the feed. It depends on sort of individual fish and on the day, really. We'll have to play it by ear and see how the fish are feeding. Hopefully they'll come to a bit of noise and a bit of sort of splash on the water. There's a few sort of cruising around in my peg now, so hopefully they'll come to a bit of noise, catapult on these into my peg. Also got 8mm, but more than likely that's probably going to be just for hook baits, really. Obviously I've got the option of the waggler, so I can move further out and do the same on the waggler line if I need to, but really I want to catch on the pole line, and by just feeding the pole line it means the fish are coming to my pole line rather than sort of further out. So ideally I'm just going to start off feeding the pole. If I need to feed the waggler, I will do. So that's what I've got for feed. Hook baits, like I've said, I've got 6 and 8mm pellets again there. I've got a few other options. I've got a pot of Powerscopex 8mm wafters, red ones, especially in venues like this where it's really coloured. Sometimes a red one can just sort of, it stands out a little bit more and the fish can pick it out. So it's worth swapping and changing between different colours, sometimes pink, red. So it's worth having a little play. Obviously being a wafter, sinks that little bit slower and gives them the chance to sort of intercept it and find it. But there's sort of no rules, if you like, when you're catching shallow. You need to play it by ear and see what's right on the day. Sometimes slow sinking bait like that can be really good. Sometimes a heavy pellet can be far better. So it's worth having a swap and change. I've also got, I had a little dig around, I had some 4mm bloodworm pellets, just another change up bait, like I said before. Red pellets sometimes can stand out that little bit more. And like I said before, slow sinking up baits can sometimes be good. So I've got some 8mm, just ready-made hookers with me. I could put a quick stop through them. What you can actually do is squeeze the oil out like that, and that actually creates a slower sinking hook bait. So sometimes that can be really good. So that's what I've got for bait and feed. Really simple, running through the rigs. So I guess it's time to catch a few fish. Right, so while I've been here, I've just started off. I'm pinging a few 6mm, about 13 metres, sort of half a dozen or so. While I've been doing that, for about a minute or so, there's a bit of fizz coming up. There's actually a few fish coming in the peg. So they're obviously confident feeding, or coming to the feed at the minute. So I'm going to start off on my shorter rig with a Carp shallow float on. I'm going to fish about 18 inches to begin with. Like I said, all the shot above the float to give it a nice slow fall. Start off on an 8mm pellet. Just makes a nice little plop when it hits the water, so it's a good starting point. If they don't like that, we can scale it down a bit and put a 6mm on and sort of change depths. But until we get a few bites, we don't really know what's right and what's wrong. So just before I ship out, I see the odd dark shadow there. Just gonna feed my peg, and then when I ship out, hopefully there's a few fish waiting. Swing the rig out beyond the pole. That means it's not under the pole tip, it's not getting the shadow, the pole's not spooking the fish. But importantly, I'm keeping a tight line between my pole tip and the float. That way you can, when you do get a bite, you're more likely to hit it, because it is quite awkward fishing with a long line. It was a silverfish then. So when you're fishing with a long line, there's a massive gap between the pole tip and the float. There's a shadow there, and see if I can swing to it. Might get him. Oh, there we go. He just came in the peg, right in amongst the feed. So while I'm, you know, fishing my peg, I'm also looking to the side, looking for fish. I think today we catch quite a lot of fish sort of in amongst the feed, which is good. So I've hit my first bite, so that's a good starting point. So just take my time with it, not a massive fish. See a big ghosty out there actually. Just gonna feed my peg, see if I can keep it there. Ready for the next fish. You quite often find sort of early on in the session that they're quite easy to catch. That ghosty's still there. And then later on in the session, we might have to fish the other rig with a longer line when they become a little bit spooky. And you quite often find sort of during the middle of the match or middle of the day, the fish sort of stop feeding anyway, so they do become harder to catch. Nice little common carp. But we're starting off on the shorter rig, because I think we are feeding quite confidently in a minute. So we've had that on an 8mm pellet, so let's go again with an 8mm. I hit the bite, so there's no need to change the depth really. If I did miss a bite, then I'd maybe think about fishing a bit shallower. Peg's fizzing as well, so there's a few fish feeding on the bottom as well. So, you know, if this was a match, I'd definitely have a rig for doing that as well. But we're just having a nice little session fishing shallow at the minute. Keep feeding my peg, get the confidence up, ready for when I ship out. like I said before, you can't slap your rig or spin the rig over the pole on this venue. It's a shame really, because it's a good way of keeping the line tight. There's a, might be a ghosty, hopefully it'll come close enough. Let's have a little go at it. There we go. It's grabbed its attention and it's gone down for it. Let's try another plop next to it. There's actually a fish coming in behind it. Let's try for that one. It's important to keep the hook bait moving all the time, because they're not really going to take a static bait, so it's not natural to them. Go back to my feed spot. Well, there are a few fish to the right, but see if we can catch one in the feed. So it's important to keep that bait moving through the water, keep swinging it out, dropping it through again. Just make sure that the bait's always moving, because when it's moving through the water, you've got more chance of catching a fish. So I'm only fishing about 13 meters to begin with, because there's no need to go longer than that really. And it also means if there is a fish like this one here, I can maneuver my pole quite easy and I've got a chance of catching them. I'm just gonna try and plop a pellet right in front of it. I was a bit too slow there. Just back out to my feed spot and I'll wait for the next one. Keep dropping the rig through in amongst that feed. It's quite important to, you know, keep feeding the peg. Some days they're not really feeding, but they do have, you know, later on in the day when it does cool down a bit, they do switch on and they do come to feed. So if you're the sort of only angler who's kept feeding throughout the day and getting their confidence up, last hour can be brilliant in amongst that feed. Making sure I've got a tight line between the pole tip and the float. Keep dropping it through. There's a few fish at the back of the peg at the minute. See if I can attract them with a bit of feed. Dropping my rig through. I think if I had the longer line rig with a mugger float on, I would have caught one then. Just didn't quite have enough line on it. It might be worth swapping to that in a minute. Like on other venues, you could sort of hang back on the feed and just slap the rig and try and draw fish in without feeding them. It's a good way of getting a bite, but here on the Glebe, the only real option is just to swing the rig out. You've got to try and attract them with the feed instead. Hi guys, sorry to interrupt this video, it's just a reminder to make sure you like the video, subscribe to Preston Innovations YouTube channel, and make sure you hit the notification bell to make sure you never miss another upload. There's actually a fish off to the left, we could try and catch that one. And while you're away from that feed peg, it gives them a bit of confidence as well to come back and feed. So I'm going to make sure the shadow of the pole's not in front of it. Flick the pellet in front of it. See if it turns. There's a slight bit of interest there. And try again. It's come to the noise. Oh, I did get a bite, I missed it. There's another one there, see if we can get that one. Might be that we need a slower sinking hook bait to catch those. They're a bit sort of, oh, there's one. I did see him, but I thought he disappeared. But he's obviously still there looking for it. Just keep the feed going in. It was just hanging off to the left of the feed. And you do find they sort of circle around. You can sort of recognise the odd fish, see it come in the feed. So they do circle around, keep coming in and out the peg, the same fish over and over. So it's important to keep it going in because they do gain the confidence and eventually they'll slip up. This one's coming in nice and steady. There's a lot of sort of 5-6 pound fish at the Glebe, but there are the odd bigger fish. That's why I've got a big net just in case. Nice mirror carp. Oh, I won't hold that one up, he's a bit lively. But because those fish did take a few attempts, it might be worth trying a few different hook baits. You could try a red power scopex wafter. Important to test it in the margins as well, just to see how it sinks. Some of the bigger ones might float if you've got a small hook on. That's really slow, that hook bait. What I might do, just to speed it up a little bit, is just nip a bit off the edges and that'll make it sink a little bit faster. You can soak it in flavourings, you know, leave it soaking there for a few months and that'll create a sort of faster sinking hook bait as well. So I've not fed for a while, I'm going to keep a bit of bait going through, see if we can draw the fish back again. Don't need to feed lots of bait, sort of half a dozen pellets now and again. And if it was a match situation, it gives you the option of dropping down on the bottom if you're not feeding too much, that is. Can't really see many at the minute. I'll drop it in the feed, might be a few there. So I've got that slower sinking hook bait this time. Some days it works, sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes you just got to sort of match the hatch. So I'm feeding pellets, so it makes sense to fish pellets on the hook as well. So you could try a red pellet. There's actually a few fish off to the right in a minute. Coming a bit closer. Let's see if we can catch one of those. No, swimming through a bit fast, those. Go back to my spot. It's fizzing like mad, so probably could have had a nice day fishing on the bottom, to be fair. Keep flicking the rig out, making sure it's dropping through, just like the loose offerings. The same with a pellet waggler. If you're casting out and leaving it, you're not really fishing a lot of the time because it's not very often they take a static bait just hanging up in the water. Got to keep it moving through like the loose feed. So there's a fish to the left coming through. See if that takes it. A couple of fish actually. Made a nice little plop as it hit the water there. Right. No, it might be that the pellet's a little bit better today. Still see a few fish though. Gonna drop it in front of that one. See if he's interested. No, I think what I could do with is a longer line, to be fair, when I'm flicking around to these fish, so I might pick up the mugger rig. Oh, there's one. So I've missed that bite and it was on a wafter. He's tangled the rig as well typically, so it's got me thinking maybe it's not the right option and maybe pellets are better. Just check it again. Give it another go, see what happens. I see a ghosty there actually. Let's see if we can catch that on camera. Just keep flicking the rig out, making a noise as it plops. And on some days, baits like maggots and casters are better. Just less noise. It depends on the fishery, what they're feeding on, really. If it's a pellet dominated venue, then fishing pellets are the way to go. But if they're used to feeding on small baits, like maggots, casters, maybe 4mm pellets, then you often find that's the best bait to use. So that took, oh no, missed it. So I think this time we'll go back to pellets. Also going to pick up the rig with a longer line because they are sort of coming in and out beyond the pole tip, so I'm going to try a rig with a longer line on it with a 4x14 mugger float on, same depth as before. This time we'll go for an 8mm pellet. In fact, I might actually try a 6mm pellet, see if that works. 13 hollow again. It's actually quite a few fish in a peg at the minute. So let's try and see if we can catch one of the cruisers that we can see. Flick it about a foot in front of it. Just wait, it's followed it down. Oh, not quite. Let's try for another one. The water's quite coloured, so can be hard for the fish to pick out the hook bait. That's why it's important to make a bit of a noise. And that, make sure I keep feeding the peg. And then keep my eye out for cruisers as they come in. So I fed some pellets and there's some fish right in amongst it. So I flick it in amongst the feed. Keep it going in. Keep the rig moving. Does make it sort of slightly harder work when you've got to swing a rig out. But the bonus side of that is you're fishing beyond your pole line, if you like. So I've got plenty of weight in that float and it just gives me a bit of control. Keep dropping the rig through, keeping a tight line out beyond the pole tip. Peg's fizzing again, so there's a few fish on the bottom. What we could do also is cut back on the feed a little bit and feed sort of 3 or 4 pellets. Just create a bit of competition and bring them up in the water. There's a fish there, just to the right. Oh, missed that bite again. Right. So that rig's about 18 inches deep. I've missed a couple bites at that depth. So I'm just going to shallow up slightly. Only about 2 inch or so. Hopefully that'll register a bit quicker on the float. And it'll lead to a few more hooked fish. See a couple fish there. Sometimes you could just flick towards a fish and the sound of it hitting the water just makes them turn and sort of swim back towards you. I think that was a silverfish. What you can also do is keep your pole off to the side and swing into the feed that way. Just make sure that, you know, that I've got the sun off to my right shoulder It just makes sure the shallow of the pole's well out of the way of the feed. Keep swinging it in amongst the loose offerings. Fish coming in to the right. Let's see if we can catch that one. Awful attempt, it's way off there. There we go. So it took a couple of attempts, but my sort of miss attempt of trying to swing towards it still created a bit of noise and let him know that there was a bit of feed in the area. And then we got him on the second attempt. So you might notice that I fish with a lot of elastic hanging out my side puller. I've just got a tight bead pulling just to sort of trap it there. But when I do hook a big fish, it tears off like that. Just gives me a little bit more cushion, if you like, because that elastic slipped through the bead and now I've got more elastic out the end of my pole. So there's less chance of the fish bottoming out and causing breakages. Venues like this are quite shallow and you find the fish do just charge off. I'm just going to take my time. I've got plenty of elastic there to help cushion. Slowly bring it back. See, while I do this, I can think about feeding my peg again and getting ready for the next fish. Typically now I've hooked this one and there's a ghostie in my peg. But I'm sure we'll get one later. So I'm just gonna feed my peg. Try and gather a few fish again. So I can see a few fish just in amongst the feed. Coming straight to the bait. Just taking my time with this fish though. That elastic's gone right through that side puller and I can bring it back through again now. Now it is a little bit awkward playing fish with such a long line, so I've probably got 5 foot of line above the float. You've just got to be careful that your top kit doesn't bend too much, because that can create breakages when you've got a short amount of elastic out when you're using a side puller. There we go. Nice mirror carp on the... Ooh. On the rig with the longer line and the mugger float. Nice looking fish. Having an awesome session here at the Glebe. Fish are really starting to feed well now and they're coming right to that loose feed. They're obviously competing for it and feeding well. It happens later on in the session at this time of year, they sort of switch on and really start feeding. That's obviously what's happening now. This fish is just charging off. It was coming in nice. I think we'll catch one or two more fish and then we'll call it a day, but at the minute there's definitely a few fish feeding in the peg. Just gonna keep that bait going in while I play this one. great thing about 6mm, you can feed them really nice and accurately. Make plenty of noise. See the odd fish cruising around, coming into the peg. So I found today that the longer rig has been best, with the longer line above the float. I think with it being so bright, it's helped to keep the pole tip away from where the fish are and where they're feeding. It's led to a few more bites. Like that fish. There should be a few more fish out there waiting for me. So go for the rig again. Just got a 414 mugger. All the shot above the float is about 16 inches deep. I found's best today. Obviously, sometimes you have to play around a little bit. Sometimes if you're missing bites, you can shallow up a little bit. Just find the sort of magic depth of where the fish are feeding. And if you're not getting so many bites, you can always drop down again. See if you get any line bites and just sort of a bit of trial and error and see where the fish are. So not feeding loads in one go, sort of four or five pellets. Make a bit of noise. Obviously, I've played that fish there. Just want to bring them back in the peg again. There's a few swirls there. And then drop my hook bait straight in over the top where that feed's gone in. So I'm not going to leave it there. I'm going to keep laying it in, making some noise and making sure that hook bait's falling through the water, because that's when they're going to take it. Not really going to take a static bait. Keep the feed going in. Obviously, I can flick my rig in amongst the feed, or if I want to, I can flick to the back or the side. Or if I see a fish, I can flick in front of that too. Just got a bit of wind starting up there, a bit of ripple. So to keep control of the rig, I've got my pole tip off to the left, so it just keeps a tight line. It's really important to keep tight line so you can hit bites. And with all that line between the pole tip and the float, it can be quite difficult to hit bites if you've got a bit of a slack line. And these fish have seen it all before, so if they feel there's something wrong, they'll spit it out straight away. So it's important to be quite quick when you get a bite. And like I said before, if you do miss a couple bites, you can always shallow up a little bit. See a couple fish there, try for them. Go out a bit further. Oh, nearly. Try again. While I'm doing that, keep the feet going in over the spot, so then I can go back to it and drop back in there. All the time I'm looking for fish sort of around the peg, and while I am trying to catch them, I'm leaving the sort of feed line alone, if you like, and letting them gather a bit of confidence without the pole tip waving around. Other things you can do, you can cut back on the feed, so try not feeding for a bit and just drop the rig in where the feed's been going in. Just makes one or two of them slip up, because your hook bait's the only one there. Ooh, there's a bite. There we go, there's another fish right in amongst the feed, that one. It's nice to have fish competing for the feed. See them coming up, swirling for it. I think we call that one the last fish and call it an end to a brilliant session at the Glebe. lovely bit of shallow fishing, one of my favourite methods, especially this time of year. It's exciting seeing fish and seeing fish before you catch them. Really nice way of catching fish at this time of year. So there we go. Nice fish to end on. Hope you enjoyed the video, and we'll see you on the bank next time.